Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing really well today. I am going to talk a little bit about my Amazon journey. So I kind of mentioned it in my last video that I left my job and I was starting something new, and I've actually been working on this for quite some time. I haven't really spoken about it on here. I didn't want to talk about it too prematurely, but I figured that now is a good time for me to kind of open up more about this new journey that I'm taking, because it is definitely a journey. Amazon and e-commerce and learning all of this, the platform and just the logistics of it. I'm still learning. I'm learning every single day. You kind of have to dive headfirst into this. And I started it, like I said, a while ago, and it's kind of a crazy story of how I began. So I watch a lot of YouTube videos, obviously. And I started watching this girl. Her name's Tatiana James. You guys probably have heard of her, and her husband, Stephen James. They create videos about personal development, investing, Amazon, living financially free, and also location freedom. So I've been watching them for a few years, and about 3 or 4 years ago, she started creating videos about Amazon and how she was making about $40,000 a month from selling on Amazon. And immediately I was like, what? I was dumbfounded. How could this be true? That's so much money. And she continued making videos about how her income was rising. So she went from making $40,000 a month, and then she was making videos about how she was making over $200,000 a month. And so a few years ago, I started researching selling on Amazon and e-commerce and all of these things, and I got too overwhelmed. I didn't know where to start, and I kind of let it go resentfully. I really wanted to try it, but I didn't know how to begin, and I felt very lost and I didn't have guidance. So I kind of let that dream of mine die, and kind of like what I spoke about in my last video about quitting my job and everything, how you work really hard and then opportunities kind of somehow arise around you, and it seems like you're getting lucky or it's fate, but the truth is you put in the work and you manifested it, and then these people or certain things come into your life. So as you guys know, I was living in Mexico. I was working remotely from Mexico, and I was sharing my whole experience, being completely transparent while I was over there. And someone started commenting on my YouTube videos, and he was actually looking into moving to Mexico and just working. He actually sells on Amazon, and he was looking to just have a base there, spend a few months over there, and he came across my channel. And he saw that I was working this job and I wasn't really happy in it, and I was creating these videos and I'd had this desire to be location free and financially free. And he saw something special in me, and he referenced Tatiana, and he told me I reminded him of her and that I could possibly do what he does and what she does. And thinking back to a couple years ago when I was going through this kind of journey of wanting to sell on Amazon and not being able to, and having this limiting mindset of scarcity mindset, I brushed it off and I told him, yeah, I tried that before and it didn't work out. It's not for me. And he was quite persistent. He kept coming back to me every couple weeks telling me, no, Natasha, I think you can do this. And he pushed me. And it was towards the end of my time in Mexico when I was about to come back to Austin, and I really was feeling lost. I really hated my job. I needed to get out of it. I wasn't sure what YouTube was what was happening with my YouTube channel. Obviously, YouTube is something I've been doing for years and I love doing it, and it is my passion and my creative outlet, and also a community that I've built here with you guys. And I love creating videos, and I would love to do this full time or have the financial freedom to be able to do this full time and not have to work my 8-to-5 job. And so I was in this big transition of moving back to the US, not liking my job, and then kind of like an angel or a message sent from above, he was pushing me to take this risk or this jump, leap of faith into Amazon. And he told me, just take this course, try it out, see if you like it, learn the platform, and then you can make your decision. And I said, you know what, you're right. Let me try, because if I don't try and you don't take those small risks of your time or energy, because this was not a big financial risk. The course that he told me to take was only $10. I said, you know what, it's worth a shot. I took the course, I started looking into it, and I was like, you know what, I can do this, I can try this out. And he was literally being my cheerleader. I'm so grateful for him because he really did push me in this direction. And it is a uphill battle at times. Some parts are super easy to get through, and then you'll hit a roadblock and you kind of want to give up and just throw in the towel. And trust me, it's been happening to me throughout this whole process. Now what, it's the end of March, and I started at the end of October or November. So, and then I also started a couple years ago, and I've thrown in the towel many times. But it's important to have those people holding you accountable and kind of giving you that motivation to keep going. So I'm so grateful for him and for a few other people who are also helping me throughout my journey, and also Tatiana. I've been binge watching her videos this whole time, and also some other YouTubers. And then another thing that came into my life with Amazon is Helium 10. They reached out to me and asked me if I wanted to use their platform, and actually you need to use a platform like Helium 10 or Jungle Scout to be successful on Amazon. It is vital to finding your products, researching your competitors, finding keywords, your SEO, everything. You really have to use one of these softwares. So I was actually so surprised when they emailed me and they told me they watched my YouTube videos about Tulum, and I was like, is this real life? So I was like, okay, I have so many people cheering me on this crazy journey of mine, so let me just keep going. You know, if you have that motivation, it's easier to just going. And I hope I am that motivation to you right now, telling you to keep going, because remember, the most successful people in the room are never the smartest people. They are the people who haven't quit. That is key. Do not quit. Take a break. If you feel overwhelmed, if you need to step back from it, take a breather, get your mind off of it, but come back and get back to work, because you can do it. I know I can do it. Believing in yourself is also very important. So today I actually want to talk about Helium 10 and kind of how I've been finding my keywords. So keyword research is so important when you're setting up your Amazon listing. It is the number one way to work against your competitors and to figure out what keywords you should rank for. Okay, let's say you choose your product. This is after you choose your product. You know all these words that could be associated with them off the top of your head, but that's limiting to your own mind and your own thought process. There are so many other ways that Amazon and Helium 10 and actual pure data can show what keywords relate to your product. And it's so important not to miss those gaps, because if you do, your competitors aren't. And they're going to rank for those keywords that you missed, and they will be able to make more sales over you. So today I'm gonna use Helium 10. I'm gonna use their Cerebro tool. This is one of the tools I've been using the most. I have to say I've been using their Chrome extension a lot, their X-ray Chrome extension for product research. But then once I found my product, I was using this tool, Cerebro, to find keywords that I could use in my listing that I could rank for, so I can hopefully get my listing on the first page and be more competitive in that area. So I'm gonna actually take my laptop, which is right here, and record my screen so I can show you guys how I do my keyword research. And I'm gonna start off here on Amazon. So I'm gonna just type in a product, and this is in my own product that I'm selling, but it is, let's just go with a random product. Let's do exercise bands for working out. So this is the bestseller resistance exercise band set for booty bands with instruction guides. So over here I have my Helium 10 plugin, which is so helpful when you're doing product research, because you can find different information, keywords, whatever it is, profitability, things like that, all with this Helium 10 Chrome extension, which I'm using right now. So I'm choosing the ASIN grabber. Okay, the number one, here it is. So let's just copy this ASIN, and then we'll come over to Helium 10. And I'm going to go into keyword research tools, and I'm going to Cerebro. So this is how you can have your product, and you have the ASIN, and then you can insert the ASIN right here, hit enter, and this will help you find other keywords that relate to this exact product. So then I'll hit get keywords here. Okay, so I hit get keywords. I have my keywords that all came up, 2,159 filtered keywords here, and you can see the search volume and the match type. This one is organic. You can see the search volume for this one is quite high. Look, it's not even a keyword in English. It's a keyword in Spanish. Banda elástica para ejercicios. So this is a keyword in Spanish. It shows that you don't even have to rank for English keywords. You can also rank for keywords in different languages, which is really important. You see the Cerebro IQ score is 6,364, which is quite high actually. And then they also have Amazon exercise bands, a lot of Spanish Lías de Ejercicio. There are a lot of keywords here that are in different languages. Hansir, I think this might be German. And then when you go over to the side, you can see organic rank, number one, sponsored rank. So then you can also pay for keywords and have sponsored keywords, which you can pay Amazon some money for, so you can rank higher for those specific keywords. That also goes into here, the column that says match type, where it says O for organic, S sponsored, and A for Amazon recommended. So this shows what the keyword is ranked for. So this is organic and sponsored, and all of that. You can also add in filters. So let's say the minimum search volume is 1,000. We want keywords that are searched for quite a bit. And then you can do organic rank, let's say 1 to 20. So this will show the keywords that are appearing on the first page. So you have 11 keywords right here. So these are all keywords that are going to appear on the first page for this ASIN. And the thing with these keywords are, for example, booty bands for legs and butt. You can choose words that you wouldn't really think of ranking for. This might show some words that you wouldn't really have thought about initially, and also words that are less competitive. So it's important to rank for words that are less competitive, because other people, your competition, might already have taken the spot for number one on certain pages. So it's important to think outside the box, think about products or thought processes that are related to your product that aren't really transparent, so that way you can be competitive from a different edge. So this is kind of how I use the Cerebro tool to do keyword research. It's really great for when you already have found your product to figure out what keywords you want to rank for. I'm still learning Helium 10, and I'm still learning all of these keyword research tools, how to set up my listings and whatnot. So hopefully as I learn more, I can share more with you guys. But if you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. Obviously, this is very different than my usual content on my channel. So I'm kind of trying to figure out how I want to share my Amazon journey with you guys. I'm thinking about setting up a second YouTube channel just for my journey, because it is a lot of work and a lot of thought goes into it. So I'd like to bring you along with me and also be able to help you as I go on. But let me know if that would be something that interests you, or you would like to learn more about this stuff, because I can definitely let you know there. Yeah, I hope you found this video really helpful. And if you have any questions, again, let me know below. Give this video a big thumbs up, hit subscribe, and hit the bell if you haven't already to keep up with me. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.